Oh, why was there white on there? What is happening? Oh, this is acetone.
I've been using it. I was wondering why my fingers felt so dry.
I just put this in here too, and I was like, oh, I should label that. And I didn't. This going back to work. If you guys watched my last project day video, it was right when he first started his second pat leave. It's not like technically a second pat leave, whatever. Anyway, I'm not getting into it. If you watched my last project video, then that was just about 2 months old now, if not more, and he's going back to work soon, and there's still a long list of projects that I need to get done in the studio. And the reason I want to get them done is because they're gonna make me be able to function more efficiently in the nail studio when I'm working on clients and when I'm filming videos. And there are things that have just kind of been pushed off to the back burner that I need to like get the frick done today. So Ivory's coming to help me. I am forever grateful for all of her help in my nail studio. I just think with my long list of things that I want to get done today, they're really like big, tedious projects. And if I'm able to have some help, like we'll just speed right through them is kind of what I'm thinking. I think where my list is. Oh, it's in my kit life. I wrote it all down in my kit life in the note section. You guys have seen this in a video before. Nail studio projects. Top three priorities are to completely reorganize my nail art storage over here. It's labeled for where I want the products to be, but the products are not in that order. They're still in a very similar order to the way that they were in my nail art collection video. So this has to be completely reorganized. I also moved my other 9-drawer unit like right beside me here, right there. And that needs to be reorganized as well. Then these last two are if we have time, but I wanna reorganize my foil drawer over there. Foils in little canisters take up quite a bit of room. So I'm trying to like implement a system that'll like not take up as much room. And I've got a bunch of glitters. This one won't take Ivory and I long. We'll probably do that one first actually, I'm thinking. I've got a bunch of glitters from Glitter Boutique Canada that I need to put in the little containers as well. She needs her own drawer though. Like Glitter Boutique Canada needs its own drawer in there because I have so many and I just don't know where to put them. So complete overhaul of reorganization today with Ivory. She's on her way over here now, which will be fantastic. So I'm just gonna get started with probably the glitter project while I wait for her.
You know, for how organized I am, sometimes I drive myself insane because I meant to pick up another one of these containers. Ignore my nails, they are like, need to be done. I meant to pick up another one of these containers from Michael's or order something on Amazon or whatever, specifically for this project because I'm out of these containers. And here we sit, a project I'm unable to complete. So I think this will be the first thing that we start with then. So to give you guys an example of what needs to be done in here, I need to separate my Fusion Colors from my Fusion Sparkles because they're each getting their own drawer. This is the Fusion Extra drawer, which just needs to be reorganized. So if you guys have watched my nail art collection, this video will show you how I've kind of downsized. Like there's a lot of things that aren't in my collection anymore. So I keep my on tops, my glows, my paints, and then any of the sun catchers or chameleons that I have left. This drawer over here is Amore, but I don't have a ton of Amore anymore. So I need to put all of my other gel lines in there. On Vogue is getting their own drawer and Beamy is getting their own drawer. So any of these other ones that are in here that are kind of smaller collections need to move up here. Glitter Heaven is pretty organized, but I have all my Glitter Boutique glitters back here and you guys saw all the ones that I have. That needs to go in a separate drawer. This one I think is fine. I don't think we have to touch this one. Nail Team glitters, I think Rose got in here at one point. They're kind of a mess. I just need to figure out what's going on here. Yeah, I don't know. The glitters are all kind of a mess. And then these foils, like I was telling you guys, they just take up so much room in here. So I'd like to find something that will work for me to better organize these. Beauty Nails for Fun, she has a really good tutorial on what she did. I just think it'll still take up quite a bit of room in this drawer. So I'm almost thinking Ivory had the idea to do a binder for these, which is what I think I might end up doing. I don't have the stuff to do that today, so I'm not sure if that's gonna get done. Light Elegance is actually organized correctly with the exception of this drawer, which is all like my paints, my buttercreams, and the new collections. And the buttercreams are gonna move over to this drawer, which is gonna move down. The brushes are gonna move down to this drawer, so I need to find somewhere to put my crystals.
That's kind of what we have on the go today.
Look who's here, everyone.
Hi, guys. Let's organize your projects from the most you want done to the least.
This is what I want most
done. Okay, so let's focus on this.
Yeah, let's do this. Okay. Let's do fusion first.
Okay, so are we... Okay, what are we doing here? Sorry.
These are all color and sparkles. Drives me insane.
So you want your colors together, your sparkles together?
Yeah, my colors in here, sparkles in here, okay. In alphabetical order.
Okay.
In both.
I'm going to put colors and sparkles, and then I'm going to let you alphabetize. I'm really bad at alphabetizing. I'm really bad at that.
Are you? I struggle with it too. I know. I wish I had it on my wall. Right? So back in elementary school.
We should just print off a little thing. Where's the paper? Let's do that.
Yeah, okay, let's do that.
These drawers were the biggest project that I wanted to tackle this day. I was just finding that it was hard for me to remember what colors Fusion All had by their name, especially when the colors and glitters were all mixed together. For some reason, I can remember Light Elegance like perfectly, whether it's a color or glitter. But with Fusion, I struggle. So I definitely wanted to separate the colors from the sparkles and have them each have their own drawer. I have to say that weeks since this video has been filmed, this project has been done. I love this. I'm so glad that I separated the sparkles from the colors, and the reason that I keep them in alphabetical order is mainly for filming. So if I need to color reference something to show you guys in a video, I can just easily find it from my swatch stick, look up the name, and then go to my collection and find it because it's alphabetically organized. Back in the day when the majority of my work was working on clients, I would have had these organized in rainbow order, but for now, this is what works way better for me.
Casualty.
Men down.
Okay, I wouldn't leave this. Like, if I was gonna organize like this, like we're going to do, I would clean this. But I would leave this forever until this drawer was going to get organized.
Are you putting anything else in this drawer?
Yeah, so this drawer is Fusion Extra. So this will be on top, glows, paints, sun catchers. Anything that's like...
Just extra Fusion, obviously, yeah. Colors or sparkles.
Yeah, exactly. But we can do the on tops, the summer on tops in here. Which are right over there. There's summer glows we can put in here. Any of the summer stuff we can put in here. There should be glows. Or did you put the new glows
in here? I put them in there, yeah.
Okay, perfect. So glows. Paints that are clean.
I can't wait to do my studio.
Yes, I can't wait to help you do your studio. Do I get to help
you? I can't wait till you help me do this studio. The problem is this is like one of the first things I'm gonna have to do.
Absolutely. That's what I said to Steve too when I moved in. Like, we set up the beds, the kitchen, and then I was downstairs working for 2 days straight.
Yeah. Talia, this has gotta stop.
In frame.
If we're gonna be nail friends,
just kidding.
Look at this lid.
It happens. So now go cure that in the light. And then it'll seal.
Yep. And then you won't be able to get your lid back on.
Yes, it will.
If all that gel was cured?
I think so. Let's see how threaded it is. Ivory, you just made a mess of this now.
Here,
the one that you just cleaned.
Oh my gosh.
It's not my fault.
Oh.
Oh my god, why was there white on there? What is happening? Oh, this is acetone.
I've been using it. I was wondering why my fingers felt so dry.
I just put this in here too, and I was like, oh, I should label that. And I didn't. This
is not no.
I'm like, why is that smudging?
Sorry.
Oh my god, why are you sorry? That's totally my fault. Let's find alcohol. No wonder why that all came off really nice in the drawer, but it's like stained now.
I hope it doesn't eat that.
It might. That's what happens. Oh my god.
My next drawer down was kind of a collect-all for a bunch of different random nail art. There was some of my Kira Sky dip powders. There was some Wildflower nail art products. It was just a random drawer, but what I wanted it to be was my Beanie Beauty box drawer. I wanted to keep all of my Beanie products in here, so we're just cleaning it out here so we can get it ready for that. While I was working on the new Beanie Beauty drawer, Ivory was working on my Amore drawer, just organizing my pixies into the color effects products so they're in alphabetical order and again, just easy for me to find. I love the Beanie Beauty Box leaf gels, and I wanted to organize them in alphabetical order again so that they're really easy for me to locate, but I use a lot of these as different accents for different types of nails, and I love that they have so many different colors and varieties. I did decide to keep all of my Beanie products in one drawer, so this is also the gel polishes as well as the embellishments that they offer, and some of their chromes ended up moving into this drawer at a later point as well. Another brand of color gels that I really like are the En Vogue color gels. They have a super thin application, but they also have some creamy products as well as some leaf type of finishes, which I'm a big fan of.
Talia, I think your nail returns drawer has to go.
I think you're right.
So this is the problem, is you get all these crazy piles of different glitters and different gels, and then you just kind of plunk them in here and then it becomes a big mess. Whereas if you had just one or two or five, then they would have empty spots and you could just literally just pop them in after every client.
But I won't do that.
But you need to. We're getting rid of it. It's gone. I'm glad we had this talk.
This is an intervention.
Oh, I found a beanie. Oh, that's not right.
Oh my gosh.
So, okay. Good talk?
I secretly know she's right, but I don't want to admit it. The nail returns drawer needs to go. But now the gels are all organized, so all other brands, such as Amore or Accents, are in the other gel drawer. And then En Vogue has their own drawer with plenty of room to grow. And we'll come back to Ivory organizing the glitters. In case you guys are wondering, this is what happens to my nails returns drawers. It turns into this giant mess of stuff that needs to be put back into my nail art organization. And it takes me forever to sort it and put it away. And in theory, this is good, except I let this sit for probably about 3 or 4 weeks. And then I have tons of stuff to put back and it just takes me way longer than it should. So you guys will be happy to know the returns drawer is gone. This is actually a project for another day, but I need the drawer that all of my foils were in to be something else. So I'm taking all of my foils out because I want to implement a better foil organization system. It just doesn't happen on this particular day, so I'm just putting all my foils in a box for next time.
What did we do then? I don't remember. I did this drawer, I know that.
I haven't even got that many new ones in though. Like, I don't know what happened in this drawer. Like, I actually don't. Like, I'm not being silly.
Yeah, I'm not sure what happened either.
Because I looked at it, I pulled it open one day and it was just a mess. And I was like, was Rose in here?
See, like, these would be rose gold to me, not you though, hey? Like,
they're pink.
Yeah, see, I don't see them being pink. So that's why I feel like I'm going to mess you up a bit.
That's fine. As long as, because I know that I'd be looking for like a reddish pink. So I'd look in that category.
I've made these pink like 4 bloody times.
Oh my God.
If you tell me you have a freaking... Oh, that's okay.
Okay. Nail returns drawer, Ivory. It's gotta go.
See? It does.
Hey, will you come back to this project?
Yeah. Yay. It'll be easy.
Well, it'll be a lot of cutting.
Why? If you're gonna use those containers, why can't you just take this and just stuff the thing in there?
Because it'd be easier if they're cut, wouldn't it? Then you just grab a piece when you're working.
Well, like, yeah, for efficiency. I don't know how big you want. Cutting foil is not going to hinder you.
That's the best use of my time. I liked that she did that. I'm moving my Swarovski crystal drawer from here. And I'm going to title it the brush drawer because I need one more light elegance drawer. So I'm going to move all of these brushes. Oh, that's something I wanted to do, was label these containers. which is easy to do. Move all these brushes down here, label these containers, and then put my buttercreams in here, which won't be too hard to organize. Yay!
Is that okay?
Let's see.
Try it out.
What did you cut them with?
What I did is I just cut both, and then I just kind of like, you can see the middle's a little bit off, but I just
kind of
like
put that at the back, actually, and then you would never utilize these on the sides of these, but like to make them longer if you wanted.
Oh yeah, and then we don't have to mess up that drawer that you just organized.
I'm gonna have Steve cut these, and then I'm gonna move these over onto the new ones, and then I'll bring them back into here because I'm not taking these out. And then
okay, right? Yes, yes.
Okay.
So we have. Are you gonna stay down here and cut these all?
Yeah, I can. Doesn't make a mess.
You're a good husband.
He's the best.
Which ones? All these?
Yeah, we'll get you some more. If you guys watched my setting up the nail studio video last year, it's well over a year old. I originally did want this done for my drawers, but I honestly thought it would take like a saw. We just didn't have it. Turns out you can use these shears and you can totally cut them down like this. If you guys didn't know, these units that I'm putting my glitters on are spice racks from IKEA. They fit perfectly in the Alex drawer units. I go into a little bit more depth on how they fit in that video, but essentially the really, really long ones fit perfectly in your small 5 Alex drawer units. These ones are the 6 drawer wide units and they don't fit perfectly in there. There was a little bit of an overhang on the one side, which is why my husband cut them down so that they do fit perfectly in here now. And then if you have the tall 9 drawer unit, you would have to cut them down as well. So I've gone over this in more details and shown more video and pictures in the setting up the nail studio video, which I'll link in the description box below. I actually think it's linked in every single one of my videos. But now all we're doing is putting the glitters what we can in rainbow order, but some of the glitters that I use are mixes, such as from Glitter Heaven or Glitter Boutique, and those are a lot harder to organize in rainbow order, so I don't even bother. I have to be honest with you guys though and say that I'm personally not loving my spice racks fitting into my drawers like this. I was so used to just kind of rolling up and seeing everything laid out horizontally that the vertically is kind of throwing me off, so I'm hoping it'll just take me some getting used to. You're definitely able to better utilize your space in your drawers if you do cut the spice racks down to fit like this. But another thing that I'm finding is you really can't see what's in the far, far back either. So again, I'm not entirely sure if I'm loving the spice racks like this. I just wanted to do that little disclaimer in case you guys are looking at trying this too. This drawer that's originally labeled for foils is actually kind of a spillover of a whole bunch of different other glitters or pigments that are different brands and don't need their own drawer. It's kind of just a collect all of glitter mixes. So I decided to do those spice racks on the left-hand side to kind of house all of the different types of glitter mixes that I have. These are also a whole bunch of different packaging as well, so it was kind of interesting to try and figure out how to best organize these. But essentially, on the left-hand side, I have all of the glitters that I got from Nail Techniques last year. I've got some Wildflowers glitters in here. I've got some of my Light Elegance Pretties. I've got some pigments going. But again, because they're all different shapes and sizes, it was kind of hard for me to organize them. I just kind of kept like with like. I also have this unit that I picked up at Walmart and houses all of my Recollections glitters that I've picked up at Michael's. There's also some flakes and different sizes of packaging as well. And then right where this little gap is, I decided to take some of those leftover bits that my husband had cut out because I did have some glitters that I wanted to fit in here as well. I actually really liked how this drawer came together as far as organization goes. It's really easy to find the different brands that I'm using and require in this specific drawer. And this drawer is going to get a new label. The labels for my drawers I will have linked in the description box as well. I will have a setup video coming up on them soon, but because of this complete overhaul of organization, a lot of the labels are changing, so I want to wait until I get new ones to show you guys how easy they are to change on and off as well. So once all the glitter drawers are organized, I can start moving all of my Light Elegance buttercreams out of the drawer that they were originally in and move them to the Light Elegance buttercream drawer that we are creating. So first things first is we need to put these in alphabetical order. For the longest time, I've kept these in collection just because they don't have a whole ton of buttercreams out yet. But now that they are releasing for a year, typically for every single season, I do want buttercreams to have their own drawer and again, organized in alphabetical order so it's easy for me for filming.
The drawer that the buttercreams were originally in is now titled New Light Elegance Products. So all of the new collections that have not been worked into the system yet are kept on the right hand side of this specific drawer. And on the left hand side, I have my gel paints and other products that Light Elegance releases. While I was busy working on my Light Elegance buttercreams drawer, Ivory was labeling all of my brush containers. Now those containers that I keep my brushes in are from Dollarama. They work perfect in these drawers and for organizing all of my different brush needs. The labels that Ivory is working with are actually from Avery and they are made to put on clothing, but I find that they stick so well to everything that I've been using on them on plastic lately, because if you just stick the labels straight from the label maker onto plastic, they probably won't hold as well. I will leave in the description box below a link to the labels that I'm talking about. But now Ivory is going back to my return drawer and just kind of organizing any of the brushes that need to be put into the brush holders. This is hands down one of my favorite drawers. I love opening this drawer up and just looking at it. You guys know that I am a hashtag brush whore. Anytime I find some really cute brushes, I am all about including them into my new collection here. But this is how this drawer turned out, and the labeling of these containers has been something that's been on my to-do list for a really long time, so I'm glad Ivory helped me tackle that. You remember that nail art that we had pulled from the Now Be Me drawer? That needs to be worked into this nail art drawer. So all I'm doing here is shuffling some stuff around to make everything kind of fit better. This one is kind of a collect-all for different nail art embellishments that I have, striping tape, feathers, anything like that. But I wanted just all of the nail art things in one drawer, if that makes sense. I didn't want to have to pull them from a whole bunch of different other drawers. You guys know I do stamping a lot and Swarovski crystals a lot, painting with watercolor paints. Those are all in separate drawers. So this is just a collect-all of a whole bunch of different ones that were in all over the place, all over my collection, if I'm being completely honest. I just needed to streamline it a bit and have everything all in one drawer. The last project that I had on my list that I thought we could tackle today was organizing this brush drawer that sits at my nail desk. You guys have seen this in my nail art tour video. This organizer that I use is a palette organizer, and I will try and link something similar. I know this specific one is not available anymore in the description box below if I can find it for you. But I've been using a bunch of different types of brushes in my collection lately, just trying out some different things, and they've all kind of made their way to this drawer that sits right beside me. This is not okay. I do not want all of these brushes in here. I want the ones that I'm using on a regular basis sitting in this drawer, not a whole ton of them. So right now I'm just sorting through the ones that I use all the time and the ones that I don't. So the ones that I don't can go back into my brush storage system. We tackled quite a few things on my nail studio projects list today. As you guys can see, there are some that I want to tackle still, so we'll have to film some more organization videos for you guys in the future. But the main things that I needed to do today was a complete overhaul and reorganization of my gels, make sure my glitters were back where they needed to be and get those all nice and organized. And the fact that I was able to organize my brushes was just a bonus. So thank you guys so much for taking the time to watch this video. I love sharing nail studio organization with you guys. You know it's a huge passion of mine, and there will be some more videos coming up on that exact topic soon. So make sure you're following me on all of my social media. I will see you guys in my next video, and thank you again, Ivory, for all of your help in the nail studio. I can't wait to return the favor in your new nail studio soon too.